Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. Just about a week ago, OpenAI released a bunch of new models and APIs, and I want to take a look at their new knowledge retrieval API, which kind of gives you a very convenient high-level abstraction for doing retrieval-augmented generation, or RAG. So I want to take a look at some code and show you a very simple example and then talk about it a little bit. So this is an API that allows you to upload files to threads of conversations that you're having with one of their models. Here's the code where you take a file. In my case, it's just a text file of a Wikipedia article. For the file that I'm doing RAG over, I decided to choose the Wikipedia article for the Sam Bankman-Fried trial because I figured that's something that happened very recently that wouldn't be in the world knowledge of the underlying LLMs. So that would be a good test case. Once you've given it a file, there's some more mostly boilerplate code that sets up your client. Note this line where you're giving it the file ID of the file you opened over here, and you're telling the API that you want to be using the retrieval tools. And once you've created that, you have to create a thread, which is a sequence of messages back and forth with the LLM. And then you can add your questions to the thread. Once you've added your prompt or your question to the thread, you go ahead and run the thread. You have to keep polling the thread to see whether the reply from the LLM is done or not. But once it's done, you can then go print out the reply from the LLM. Okay, let's run this and try asking it a few questions. For my first question, I'm going to ask how long the jury took to reach a verdict. And it says the jury took approximately 5 hours, began 3:15 November 2nd. Which is what the Wikipedia article says. So it seems to be getting the correct ground truth facts from the document that I gave it. Let's try a couple more questions. Who were the prosecution lawyers? Nicholas Roos and Daniel Sassoon, which again is correct according to the Wikipedia article. Now, the thing to note is that it gives back a citation, a link to a source, which according to the documentation is supposed to be present in this annotations part of the reply and link back to the part of the source document where this answer was derived from. And that seems to be empty. I noticed that other people like Simon Willison, who were also trying out this API, saw a similar problem. So I'm not sure if this is a bug or if I'm just missing something in the way I'm invoking the API, but a proper citation with every reply would be really cool. So I think this is a really significant new API. It gives you one well-packaged, clean API to do RAG over a set of documents that you upload. In this example, I just uploaded one document and asked questions about it, but you can upload multiple documents. This saves you a lot of fiddling around and writing your own code for things like chunking and inserting into a vector database and then looking up that vector database. Note that we didn't have to do any of that in this code that we wrote that uses the new OpenAI Assistance API. So all those details are now behind this one-stop abstraction. Now that could be an advantage, or if you're really looking for that level of control, that could also be a disadvantage. Maybe your application really needs that level of control where you want to control how the document is chunked, what the ranking for your vector similarity looks like, and all those details that have to do with chunking the document and looking up the vector database and so on. But maybe what OpenAI is telling us here is that all those details don't really matter to the quality of the retrieval or the quality of the answers you get. That's kind of what I'm reading between the lines. Anyway, so that was a quick look at OpenAI's new RAG API. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please consider subscribing, like the video, and I will see you next time. Thank you very much.